In the last few videos, we looked at tabs and how they work. In these next couple of videos, we're going to take a look at tables, and I'm going to try and show you why tables may be better than tabs in many cases. Here we have an employment application form, on the top created with tabs and underscores, on the bottom using a table. John Doe wants to apply for this job. He types in his name at the top, last name, Doe, and we see that the lines shift. Then I need to use my mouse to get over, or I can use my arrow keys to type in the first name. But everything still seems to shift out of place. Using the table, typing in the last name, I'm using my tab, and everything lines up and looks nice. And if I try and change the text last name, I get an error saying no modifications will be accepted for that part of the employment application. Turning on our non-printable characters, we can see our tabs and underscores on the top. On the bottom, it looks the same. But to make it look a little nicer, let's turn on our table boundaries. With our table boundaries on, we can see a table is almost like a calc spreadsheet inside of the Writer document. Clicking on the last name, when I was going to the first name, I would tab over and the next cell was first name. Then I got to the first name entry. Going back to the first name, if I try and change that, it was giving me an error that was read only. Now this isn't foolproof protection. You can get around it. It's just to prevent accidental updating of that information. Here we have another example. This is a garden club meeting agenda. On the top again with tabs and on the bottom in a table. Joe Greenthumb wants to change his topic from importance of fall fertilizing to home vegetable gardens, both tasty and nutritious. When we change this, it goes over into the next tab area. So to fix this, we need to take nutritious down to the next line, tab over, then take Joe Greenthumb, cut that, get back over to our next tab area, and it's not quite that easy. Down in our table, I'm just going to select my importance of fall fertilizing and paste. That's all there is to it. Now Karen Johnson has to leave early. Using our tabs and underscores to take her out, I highlight the name, delete it, and to get Joe Greenthumb up, I need to cut that, move up a line, paste. Take Patty Smith, cut that, and go up a line and paste. Not real difficult, but not real easy either. Using our tables, I just select the name, delete it, and Joe Greenthumb comes right up. Let's take a quick look at those table boundaries by going up to Table, Table Boundaries, and turning them on. Here we can see the table behind the agenda. And looking at our tabs, turning on our non-printable characters, that looks a little messy. A little easier to read with our table. Whether you think tables are the better way to go or not, it's totally up to you. Both ways are available. But you should know how both ways work.